Welcome, everybody.
Welcome
We're
back
in Summers.
To EarthBound. We are in Summers.
Oh, I gotta silence that.
Oh,
silence is golden.
Annoying. Why are you wandering around? Summers is a posh resort made for adults. Why do I keep pressing that button?
So, Summers is not like a country. It's like a resort.
Yeah, well, it's a place. It's a place like Winters.
I wonder if the big monster is Nessie.
Maybe. I don't know. We'll see.
Spoilers. Jeff just said no.
We'll see. Hi, welcome to my store. What do you need?
Didn't we already buy stuff?
I think so. I was just double checking. Lucky coins are so expensive, dude. Okay.
Dude, cool. Hold on.
Did we what? Yeah, we did everything.
We did?
Yeah, I think so. Everything that we've done. Well, we haven't done anything yet. We just got here, but I should become a porter.
Get all the tips from the old
Look at this
folks.
Guy. Look at this guy. Hey, stop putting your grimy fingerprints all over my car, you little punk.
I'll take it. Dump on your car is what I'm gonna do. What are you doing?
I'm rubbing my junk on his car, dude.
That's indecent.
Dude, yeah, well, he was being a dick.
I would rather just, like, poop on it. Instead of rubbing my genitalia on it. That's not good for your genitalia.
I mean, it's covered by my pants. I didn't whip it out.
Oh.
I can make an order to go.
I guess that's okay. It's just strange. Looking.
Should I get crack and
pasta de Summers?
Pasta de Summers. All right. I don't think I need to be here, but I'm gonna talk to everybody.
Braised boa.
Does that person? Oh, you're not the waiter. Does that person look like Paula to you?
A little bit. Long lost mother.
Salmon? Please, we do not have such trash on our menu.
Salmon. Come
Who
on.
Eat? Ooh, sorry. You know,
oh, look at the seagulls.
Iced coffee, dude. Iced coffee. He's drinking iced coffee. Are those seagulls or those clouds? Yeah, they're seagulls,
those are seagulls.
Yeah,
because it's the beach.
Oh, found a spot, dude. Taking a photo.
Look at that totem.
Good photo op. Oh, he's just on the fucking table? Did he land in that person? Is there a person there?
It's God.
Or am I crazy?
God's
no, wasn't there a person at
there
that
might
table?
Have been, but
I didn't notice until
they probably don't even notice because he's
only we can see him. Yeah, old lady there. I want to talk to her and see if she's like, did you see that old man on my table?
Is that
I have fake teeth, so I like soft foods.
Not like rocks or stones. They're too hard.
That's not a food, you weirdo. Breaking into the room and checking their drawers for value. How is it anything like that?
Well, I mean, I guess it's an invasion of your privacy, but that makes no sense.
Yeah, alright, I'm gonna get out of here. I'm gonna progress this shit.
You can tell this is a fancy restaurant because they don't have any booths.
No booths, only tables.
That's my type of place.
Have we talked about booths and tables on this show?
Not on the show. Here's the thing. I'm of the opinion that you're one of two types of people.
Thank you again, Poke. Mr. Wozgy. Shit, dude, Pokey was here. Welcome to Lohel de Summer.
Richmond.
Awesome. But we don't have any reservations on your name. However, we can offer you room at $450.
What is this? No.
Do I need
malarkey.
It? Do I need it? No, I don't need it. I'm good.
No.
I'm gonna save it, though.
No. I know, Mimsy. No, but I say that there's
booths.
Two types of people in the world.
Okay.
You're either a booth person or you're a table person.
I didn't
person.
Record. It's okay. It doesn't matter.
And it says something about you at the different places that you want that you'd prefer to sit.
Sure. Yeah.
I will agree that there is. Jeff and I had a big argument over this one time.
I just didn't fit your mold, Roger.
Well,
I just didn't fit your booth table mold.
Just wanted you to let me in. I've been obsessing over
Jesus
wrecking
Christ
ball.
Everywhere. Okay.
Oh, fuzzy pickles right
go
now.
Go on, booth Jeepers. Table.
Yeah, I think that you either you at least depending on the situation, sure, but for the most part, you have a preference whether you are a booth or a table person.
Sure.
If somebody's like booth or table, and you have a initial response, knee jerk response, it's like I'm gonna be booth and table. In my past, I would have qualified myself as a booth person if you asked me like 5 years ago. Now I'm a table person.
Yeah,
ooh. I'm definitely a table person. If you ask me, booth or table, 9 times out of 10, I'll say table.
So what makes you a booth person and what makes you a table person?
I think that a booth person wants, it's when you're eating something, you want more privacy, you kind of want to be blocked off. And table's a lot more open, it's a lot more accessible, it's a lot more vulnerable.
Yeah. So it's like sitting in the front or the back of the class.
Kind of, yeah. That's right. What I equate it to.
Yeah, yeah.
To where different circumstances might be, oh, yeah, I need to sit at the front of the class. Or, oh, it's the only table left. Sure, I'll take the front of the class.
Yeah.
I used to sit at the front of the class because I didn't know that I needed glasses. And so I just thought that that's, like, where you could actually see things.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, monster named Kraken lives in the open sea.
The Kraken!
Are you scared?
The Kraken!
I'm assuming I'm gonna see a Kraken, dude.
Yeah, and then I got my eyes checked for the first time, and then I realized that I needed glasses, like, halfway through high school. And then I realized that there was a whole world that I wasn't seeing because I didn't have glasses.
So east of here is Toto.
I bless the rains out in Africa. I bless the rains.
That's such a great song. The, such great harmonies.
My co-worker, would you like a boat ride?
Yes.
Would you like a boat ride?
Ooh, I don't feel like sending a ship out. I'm worried about my wife.
Oh, there we go.
I'm not afraid of the Kraken.
The Kraken?
My wife's totally ignoring her magic cake business. These days, she spends her time hanging out in a strange club. We no longer have any mutual interest to discuss. Is our relationship over? Sigh.
Yeah, I think that booth people, though, I think, if you're a booth person, you kind of like your own privacy. You don't want to kind of be out there. I also don't like booths. I think I've changed my mind on booths because I don't like how I can't sit closer to the table.
I feel like tables
and booths nowadays...
They're super spread out.
Yeah, they're super far out.
This guy's going to talk to us about... you need to call a secret number for a reservation if you want to get in. What? Ooh, yeah, I'll give you the secret number. It's a strange place. All right, dude, you want to go to the Stoic Club?
Yeah, sure, I don't care.
Oh, shit.
Oh, you're
hello?
Dead. Hello, cheese.
Hello, cheese? Oh, happy day. I finally got a hold of you. Oh, cheese, it's Tony, dude. Oh, it's Tony from Winters. I'm collecting players' names for a school project. You know, players just like you. That's right, you, the one holding the controller. Would you register your name, please? Don't spell your name wrong.
Okay, hold on. Do Vladimir Tootin.
Okay. In all caps?
Yeah.
Of course.
Vladimir Tootin. No, do it all together.
Oh, just one big word?
Vladimir Tootin.
Is it?
I-N.
I-N.
Tootin.
In the apostrophe.
Tootin.
Apostrophe or no?
And then put up
in
a-
music note?
No, and
then- Oh, music note!
No, go back. Do up, Vladimir Tootin, and then do up a storm.
Does it fit?
Yeah, totally. It will. Vladimir tuned up a storm! Music note. See?
Vladimir tuned up a storm is our player name.
Thanks, game player. Thank you very much.
Is this correct?
Oh, it's right.
Oh, it is absolutely correct, my friend. I apologize for any trouble this may have caused you. Don't put my friend Cheese in any dangerous situations, okay?
He's breaking the fourth wall.
I really do. Well, yeah, he is. He's talking to us. He's talking to Vladimir tooting up a storm.
Zora, did you just poop? Because you're going all over
the place. She must have. Cheese! No, she just ate. I hope that I can see you again when you're feeling up to it. From T-O-N-Y.
Why? Because I said so!
Well, I've been on the phone too long. Gotta go! Good luck! Take care so long! This time I'm really gonna hang up. Goodbye,
B. No, you hang up, Tony.
No, you hang up. No, you hang up. I honestly don't think there's much out this way.
Tables are too... if you get the table, you can sit up really close,
though.
It's
true.
And then I can read my book.
What about the tables with the chairs that are, like, bolted to the floor?
Yeah, like a McDonald's situation?
Yeah, yeah, where, like, you can't even move the chair. Then it's, like, the worst...
I still like that, though. I would rather have that than the booth.
Okay, because it's a little open. You almost get your own little personal space more.
Yeah.
Like, you get party personal space with a booth.
Yeah.
But you get individual personal space
with
the
table.
Table.
Yeah, that's what I... And
yeah. Wozgie picked up the receiver.
I just like the tables.
Stork... Hello, this is the Stoic Club.
Oh, Wozgie, sir.
Would you like to make a reservation?
Absolutely.
Certainly. We are looking forward to having you here. Thank you. Click beep, beep, beep. Well, this is a great place to end the episode, so tune in next time when we head over to the Stoic Club, and we'll see what they have in store for us. Or did you want to talk about booth and table more?
No, we're good.
We're good. I think you made your points.
Have you ever been to Culver's? Those things, those booths? That space in between? Huge.
Huge. You have to sit at the very edge of it. You're on the edge of your seat. You're like the entire...
Well, eating this buttery, fucking beautiful piece of burger.
Those butter burgers. Dude, they're amazing.
Gained 3 waist sizes.
And he gained... And the Grinch gained 3 waist sizes that day.